WIXQ is owned by Millersville University and operated by the students as an extracurricular activity. The opinions expressed on air are those of the DJs and do not reflect the views of WIXQ or its staff. Seize the airways with WIXQ, 91.7 FM, The Ville. Radical, renowned, real college radio. We are back here on the air here in WIXQ 91.7 FM. This time for us to go through our What's Going On in Sports segment. And then from there, it'll get into the meat and potatoes of the show, which is mainly about Frank. So his top five. And our top five this week is going to be the top five TV series. And then also Frank's free speech. Everybody get ready for that. Because I don't know what's going to be coming out of his mouth, but I don't think he does either. So keep it a little sane going through sports quick. All right, so top 25 college football scores. We'll go through those quick and our predictions for the next top four rankings for the college football playoffs. So let's get it started with number 12, UCF going over top of Temple, 52-40, and that was last Thursday. And then we'll go through the top 10 here. So top 10 scores. So Alabama over number 3, LSU, 29-0. We had number 2, Clemson over Louisville, 77-16. Number 4, Notre Dame over Northwestern, 31-21. Number 5, Michigan spanking Penn State. Number 14, Penn State, 42-7. We have number 6, Georgia over top of number 9, Kentucky, 34-17. Number 7, Oklahoma over Texas Tech, 51-46. Number 8, Washington State over top of California, 19-13. And number 10, Ohio State over top of Nebraska, 36-31. So the top four for the college football ranks, I think, is going to be happening this week. We're going to have Alabama still at number 1. Number 2, we're going to still see Clemson. I think Notre Dame goes up to number 3. And Michigan swipes into the number 4 spot. So there's going to be your top 4 going into next week for the college football playoff rankings. Of course, they will all change until the end of the year when we get ready for the bowl season. Along with that, we're going to go through the NBA scores very quickly here. So we have the 76ers over the Detroit Pistons, 109-99. Have the Charlotte Hornets over the Cavaliers, 126-94. Have the Indiana Pacers over the Boston Celtics, 102-101. The Atlanta Hawks over the Heat, 123-118. The Bulls falling to the Rockets, 96-88. Have the Pelicans falling to the Spurs, 109-95. Denver Nuggets over the Utah Jazz, 103-88. And the Los Angeles Lakers going over top of the Trailblazers, 114-110. Along with that, what we have here is the NHL scores before we get into our NFL scores and NFL schedule for the week. So right here, what we have is from last night's game, have the Sabres going over top of the Senators, completely just taking them to town. 9-2 is the final score. Have the Tampa Bay Lightning over the Canadiens, 4-1. Have the Devils falling to the Islanders, 3-0. The Oilers over top of the Red Wings, 4-3. Have the Maple Leafs blanking out the Pittsburgh Penguins, 5-0. Have the Stars going over top of the Capitals in overtime, 4-3. Have the Wild over top of the Blues, 5-1. Bruins falling to the Predators, 1-0. Have the Hurricanes falling to the Golden Knights, 3-0. Blackhawks falling to the Flames, 5-3. Have the Sharks over top of the Flyers in overtime, 4-3. And the Columbus Blue Jackets have fallen to the LA Kings, 4-1. And for our last thing here, we have the NFL segment for this week. We'll go through the schedule quick, and then we'll get back to more music before we get ready for Frank's free speech. So today's games, we have the Chicago Bears taking on the Buffalo Bills at 1 o'clock. These are all 1 o'clock games, by the way, everyone. Have the Cleveland Browns taking on the Kansas City Chiefs. I'm not feeling too good about the game. I think the Chiefs are on the Cleveland Browns there in Cleveland, Ohio. Have the Jets taking on the Dolphins, the Lions and the Vikings, Falcons and the Redskins, Buccaneers and the Panthers, the Steelers and the Ravens. And then for our 4 o'clock games today, we have the Texans and the Broncos, Chargers and the Seahawks, Rams and the Saints. And then for Sunday night football, we have the Packers and the Patriots. And from this past Thursday's game, we had the 49ers over the Raiders, 34-3, behind third-string quarterback Nick Mullins, tossing 3 touchdowns and 262 yards in the air. And for Monday night football, we have the Dallas Cowboys and the Tennessee Titans going on in Arlington, Texas at AT&T Stadium. So, ladies and gentlemen, let us get back to some more music, and we'll come back and do Frank's free speech and our top 5 movies, or not top 5 movies, top 5 TV shows movies were last week. Top 5 TV shows series that Frank and I have ever seen, and try to get some controversy thrown in there Frank's way. So, thank you everyone for tuning in. Stay right here on WIXQ 91.7 FM. You are listening to What is Savage.
Behold the King, the King of Kings. On your knees, dog. All hail. From the place where the traitor lost both his name and his face. Through the halls and the corridors, stinking in blood, he tasted his grin, and it tasted good. The king took his head, left him broken and dead.
unable to tell. The king took their heads, and he sent them to hell. Their screams echo loud in the place of their death. Ripped open, they die with their final breath. They hail the king, the king of kings.
In New York City, I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty, yes you do. Times Square can't shine as bright as you, I swear it's true. Hey there, Delilah, don't you worry about the distance, I'm right there. If you get lonely, give this song another listen, close your eyes. Listen to my voice, it's my disguise, I'm by your side. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 What you do to me. Delilah, I know times are getting hard, but just believe me, girl, someday I'll pay the bills with this guitar. We'll have it good, we'll have the life we knew we would, my word is good. Hey there, Delilah, I've got so much left to say. If every simple song I wrote to you would take your breath away, I'd write it all. Even more in love with me, you'd fall. We'd have it all. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 1,000 miles seems pretty far, but they've got planes and trains and cars. I'd walk to you if I had no other way. Our friends would all make fun of us, and we'll just laugh along, because we know that none of them have felt this way. Delilah, I can promise you that by the time we get through, the world will never ever be the same, and you're to blame. Lila, you be good and don't you miss me. Two more years and you'll be done with school, and I'll be making history like I do. You'll know it's all because of you. We can do whatever we want to. Hey there, Delilah, here's to you. This one's for you. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 What you do to me.
I'm wide awake. Angry Young and Poor is an independently owned record and clothing store that has been selling everything punk rock since 1995. They have an extensive collection of new and vintage vinyl records, punk and metal t-shirts, leather jackets, and Doc Martens. Angry Young and Poor is located on 356 West Orange Street in Lancaster. They are open from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. every day except Wednesday and Sunday. More information can be found on their website, angryyoungandpoor.com, or by calling 717-397-6116.
Surprise! You're in for a shock.
The Snapper.
Since 1925, Millersville University's principal source for news, sports, entertainment, and more. Don't forget to pick up a free copy of The Snapper every week to keep on top of the latest events on campus and the rest of the world.
WIXQ would like to thank The Snapper for supporting great college radio. Be sure to check out The Snapper or their website, thesnapper.com.
The Snapper!
The following is made possible by Dad.
Why was the basketball court all wet? Because the players kept dribbling all over it.
The Dad Joke. Corny, groan-worthy, but also one of the simplest ways to share a moment with your kids.
Why do you have to be careful when it's raining cats and dogs? Because you might step in a poodle.
And kids that spend more time with their dads grow up to be smarter, more successful.
Can I tell you a cat joke? Just kidding.
And, with any luck, funnier adults.
Why didn't the skeleton go to the dance? Because he didn't have any body to go with.
Dad jokes rule. So take a moment to make a moment and give your kid a laugh. It's as easy as going to fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
That's really funny.
WIXQ is now on the Radio FX app. Radio FX is the ultimate college radio provider, allowing you to interact with WIXQ in new and exciting ways. Connect with your favorite DJs and participate in polls and potential giveaways. The Radio FX app is available on iOS and Android devices. Download now and seize the airwaves with 91.7 WIXQ.
She's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her head. She acts like summer and walks like rain. Reminds me that there's a time to change. Since the return of her stay on the moon, she listens like spring and she talks like June.
broke into the stadium and I wrote your number on the 50-yard line. You were always a perfect one and a valedictorian, so under your number I wrote, call for a good time. I only wanted to get your attention, but you overlooked me somehow. Besides, you had too many boyfriends to mention, and I played my guitar too loud. How do you like me now? How do you like me now? Now that I'm on my way, you still think I'm crazy standing here today. I couldn't make you love me, but I always dreamed about living in your radio. How do you like me now? When I took off to Tennessee, I heard that you made fun of me. Never imagined I'd make it this far. Then you married in the money, girl. Ain't it a cruel and funny world? He took your dreams and he tore them apart. He never comes home and you're always alone, and your kids hear you cry down the hall. Alarm clock starts ringing, who could that be singing? It's me, baby, with your wake up call. How do you like me now? How do you like me now? Now that I'm on my way, you still think I'm crazy standing here today. I couldn't make you love me, but I always dreamed about living in your radio. How do you like me now?
Stop, midnight, T-top, Jack in her cherry coke town. Mama and daddy put their roots right here, cause this is where the car broke down. Yellow dog school bus, kicking up red dust, kicking us up by barbed wire fence. MTV on the RCA, no AC in the vents. We were Jesus, Sammy, blue jean baby, born in the USA. Trailer park, truck stop, faded little map dots, New York to L.A. We were teenage dreaming, front seat leaning, baby, come give me a kiss. Put me on the cover of the Rolling Stone, uptown, down home, American kids. Growing up in little pink houses, making out on living room couches, blowing that smoke on Saturday night. A little messed up, but we're all right. Church parking lot, trying not to get caught. Take her home and give her your jacket. Making it to second base by saying you went all the way Monday afternoon at practice. Sister's got a boyfriend daddy doesn't like. Now he's sitting out back 30-30 in his lap in the Blue Bug's afterlife. We were Jesus, Sammy, blue jean baby, born in the USA. Trailer park, truck stop, faded little map dots, New York to L.A. We were teenage dreaming, front seat leaning, baby, come give me a kiss. Put me on the cover of the Rolling Stone, uptown.
kids. Growing up in little pink houses, making out on living room couches, blowing that smoke on Saturday night. A little messed up, but we're all right. Sammy, blue jean baby, born in the USA. Trailer park, truck stop, faded little mad dots, New York to LA. We were teenage dreaming, front seat leaning, baby, come give me a kiss. Put me on the cover of the Rolling Stone, uptown, down home, American kids. Growing up in little pink houses, making out on living room couches, blowing that smoke on Saturday.
Welcome back. It's time for our top five TV shows of the
week. Calm down. You're like screaming. All right,
well,
go.
Sorry, because I just had my headphones in, so when that happens, I mean, I get a little loud sometimes. So it's all right. So you're going first or am I going first?
You're going. You know what? I'll go first. I'll go first.
All right.
I don't want you to upset people. So, God.
Nobody's going to get upset. Don't worry.
All right. Well, we're going to do our top five segments. Top five. These are TV series we have seen. This is going to be a bit of a variety just because there is a top 100 TV shows of all time. But this is going to be our top five individual shows of all time.
Mm-hmm.
So this may differ from other people's opinions. So I'll start it out. Top five. My number five is going to be The Walking Dead. Before it got all weird, I actually enjoyed watching The Walking Dead. It's been on for a very long time, I believe since 2010 or 11. So it's been happening for a couple years, couple seasons in, and it was something you would emotionally get involved in and something you could actually watch, and it would take an hour of your time, but it would feel like it wasn't even an hour. So as number one, or number five, I mean. Number four, I'm going to go with The Golden Girls. The Golden Girls is a pretty good show. I never knew much about it until a couple years ago. And when I started watching it, I'll tell you what, I turn that on every night and I watch it because it's a good show. Frank, you should watch The Golden Girls. Have you've heard of The Golden Girls?
Yes, I've heard of The Golden Girls.
Have you watched The Golden Girls?
I have not watched it.
You should watch The Golden Girls. It's a pretty good show. All right, so number three, I'm going to go with Friends. That's a very, you know, typical 90s show that everyone typically knows about. People our age have gotten very emotionally involved into Friends. I think it's just the culture of it. So it's number three in itself. Number two, I'm going to go with The Office. Steve Carell is what makes that show so great, playing Michael Scott. Right when Steve Carell walked away from the show, then that's when it started going downhill. So there's more good than bad with that show. So I'm going to say The Office with number two. And number one, I'm going with Seinfeld. Because, you know what, I love that show. And I have the complete series. I got that as a Christmas gift a couple years ago. So I can watch that all the time. I can watch every episode, and it would never get old just because of the comedy that's within it. So there's my top five. Frank, go ahead, give me your top five.
All right, so I'm doing my top five comedy shows that I think are funny. Now, just because you think they might not be funny doesn't mean that my opinion isn't valid. So
I already have a guess on what some of them are, so go ahead.
All right. So, number five, Modern Family. I used to watch that show back when it was, like, really popular.
Before you continue, you do know this is top five shows, not comedy shows?
Well, to me, I'm doing my top five comedy shows.
Okay, that's fine. I didn't know if you watched dramas and, you know, Cartoon Network.
Yeah,
and
but I mean, I prefer
Franklin.
I like a good comedy on TV, so that's what
Nick
I'm doing
Jr.
today. Well, I'm a little old for that, but anyway. So number five, Modern Family. I used to think back in the day it was funny. I mean, I haven't really watched it that much lately because I have other shows to watch. So I'm just gonna put that as my number five.
Yeah, don't say what the other shows are because you will get a strike.
Well, number four is 30 Rock.
I knew you were going to mention that eventually.
Because, you know what? I think it's very funny. Tina Fey is very funny. She's a very good writer, and I think she's very funny, in my opinion. And everyone else on that cast was made it funny too, so that's why it's number four. Number three, I have Parks and Recreation.
I knew that was coming.
Because, you know what, I love Amy Poehler. I think she's hilarious, and like I said, like, for the last show, everyone made it funny, and even though, like, there are a couple characters who I didn't really like, but he was, like, I think he got fired after the first season, so I think it made the show better after he left.
Who?
You know, I forget his name.
What did he play?
He was just one of the, like, office workers there.
Okay.
I forget his name, but I think he left first season, so everyone else made it funny except him. Number two, I have The Office. Like you said, Steve Carell is very, very, very funny, and although I would say even though, like, don't give me a strike for this, but I'm gonna say it anyway. I thought, like, even though he's a very funny person, I feel like some things that he would say were a little cringy.
Strike.
Very funny.
That's a strike-a-rooney.
I do not care if you're going to give me a strike or not, okay? Because it's my opinion.
You're getting all soft on me. That's a strike.
My opinions do not matter to you. It's my opinion, so you can't give me a strike.
You're right. Your opinions do not matter to me.
But you can't give me a strike for having an opinion. You can give me a strike if I said something like, that's offensive, but that's not offensive.
You basically just said he was offensive.
No, I mean, I just said there's a few things that he said were a little cringy, but
that's what made it funny.
Yeah, but sometimes he took it, like, over the top.
Did you find it offensive?
I didn't find it offensive. I just thought, like, some things, like, it was just, like, not funny, but it was just, like, it's awkward. Just okay. Watching. Yep. And then my number one show is Superstore. I think it is hilarious. And I do not care if you're going to give me a strike for that one, because it is funny.
Look, I'm not going to give you a strike, because I'm just glad you didn't mention any other shows, talk shows or anything. So.
Well, because I thought, you know, I do comedy shows. I mean, my talk shows, that's a whole different story.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Why Super Shoe Store?
Superstore.
Yeah.
Because, you know what, the cast is very diverse, and everyone is very funny. They make lots of good references to the world of retail, which I have experience in, so that's why I can relate to that show.
Are you going
to
stay in the world of retail forever?
I mean, not forever. I mean, obviously, I'm probably going to try to, like, move on and do something else, but, I mean, for now, I love it.
You have no idea what you're going to do after that store, do you?
I don't know. Maybe I'll stay there for a little while. I'll stay there for maybe a couple of years until I find a real, like, thing. But for now, I like it.
Okay. Is that it?
That's all I got.
Any honorable mentions?
Not really. I mean, if there's one show, I think The Middle, I think it ended. But, I mean, I used to watch it, like, back in the day. But, again, like, Modern Family, found other shows to watch. So, I mean, I used to think it was funny, but I haven't watched it in years, so.
I'll tell you what. I'm going to tell you now to get you prepared. These are going to be our top fives over the next 2 weeks, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because in 3 weeks, it's Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
We will be on break. There will be no show.
Oh, I have an idea for a top five.
Give me your top five before I give you the top five.
How about top five Thanksgiving foods?
That was honestly going to be next week.
Well, no, not next week. How about the week before our last?
The week before our last will be the top five things we're thankful for.
Okay.
But because we have guests next week, it would be interesting to get top five foods.
Yes.
So it'll be top five Thanksgiving foods next week. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, I'm excited for that one.
And since you want to give our guests their shout outs again, these will be the guests that will be also giving their top five Thanksgiving foods.
Oh, you want me to do the shout out now?
Yeah.
Okay. Brittany, Sean, and Chris.
And?
You and me.
And?
Brittany, Sean, Chris, you, me, that's it.
No, one more person's coming.
Wait, you said, no, you told me it was just going to be us.
One person's going to be coming along.
Oh, Ava.
Can't believe you forgot about her.
I'm sorry. Well, I wasn't sure if she was coming or not, because, I mean, she's only a month old, so I thought maybe somebody would be watching her at home. Well, I guess, I mean, I don't know how it works, but
do you want to get up at 7 o'clock in the morning and wait and watch her?
I mean, but I have to be here, though.
All right, then. I wouldn't trust you anyway, so it's okay.
I mean, I've babysat before, so I know what I'm doing.
Your dogs, that's about it.
I mean, well...
And your dogs run away.
No,
they get
true.
Out the doors and run
she
away.
She does not run away. Well, she's been running away. Not lately, but like, she...
To the neighbor's yard saying, help me, save me from this man. It's right?
No, that's not true. My dog loves me.
I probably know why they ran away too.
You
know,
every time I come home, she always like hides. Comes up to me. No, she comes up to me with her tail wagging everywhere and then like going, grrr.
Yeah, I hate you, I hate you, I hate you.
No, she's like, feed me, give me something.
I know why they run away.
Why?
Because they don't want to be in trouble like you get in trouble, like that time that we had to go to Walmart to go fill up canola oil because you used all the canola oil at your house. You remember that? And then you tried to sneak it back in to show your parents that you didn't use any of the canola oil.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, yeah. Your dogs didn't want to be linked in with that, so that's why they run away to the neighbor's house, you know? I don't know
one.
That guy.
Stop saying they. I only have
but
one
at
dog.
The time, you had two dogs.
Yeah, at the time.
That's what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
I'm speaking about that time.
Okay.
They didn't want to be around when you were getting in trouble, so that's why they said, neighbors, help me and save me.
Well, dogs, I don't think dogs think that way.
Oh, yeah? What do they think about?
They just think about taking naps, chewing bones, and eating. That's all they think about.
Yeah, chewing your bones, eating.
Chewing my bones.
Yeah, because you keep bringing them back. When's the last time one of your dogs ran away? Yesterday?
She didn't really run away lately, but like she would go to the neighbor's yard, and then sometimes she'd be near the street, and I'd have to like. I'd have to chase her back into the house. I'm like, Maggie, you can't go that way.
Okay. Okay. All right. Is that it?
I think it's time for a break.
Okay. All right. We'll do a commercial break. We will be playing music for a little while because coming up, we'll have Frank's free speech, but we need to have some time to take a break from Frank. So... we're going to play some music for a good solid 15, 20 minutes after these commercial breaks. And then we will come back and do Frank's free speech. And we'll also have our inspirational and your uninspirational quote for the week. So stay tuned right here with us on WIXQ 91.7 FM. Tune in at about 9:15 or so to listen in on your Frank's free speech. So thank you for tuning in.
In celebration of our 50th anniversary, WIXQ has brought back personalities from the past to discuss their time at the station and just how much it has meant to them.
Hey, my name is Brian Mitchell. I was production assistant 2004, 2005, and then chief announcer until about 2008. My buddy actually got involved first. His name was Bernie, who was also on console as well. He got in about a semester before I did, and then I just started, because we were friends, just hanging out down here. And I was like, this place is fantastic, and I need to get in on this. So became a DJ, and then immediately... went in for console membership. I know I was deep like 2 a.m. to 4 a.m. to start, and then I ended up getting like a Friday, Saturday shift as well, so prime time. It was called When Dinobots Attack. Obviously, play on words with Transformers. I'm a very big nerd, big geek like that. I introduced like the show promos, so everyone to get involved with WIXQ, to get to know the console and to get to know other people, had to do a show promo. Whether it was a 30-second clip that you wanted me to play or you wanted to come in here and spitball back and forth, come in, introduce yourselves, let's get to know everyone who plays music here, not just the people on console. There's so many groups on campus, and I've been in a lot of those groups, but there's no family, you know? This was just completely a family. It is, without a doubt, some of my fondest memories being here. It was always a place to go, and it was a home. You didn't want to be in your dorm. You didn't want to be with the same people all the time. It didn't matter who was on, what they were talking about. That door was open, and it was so welcoming. You know, and even, hey, I'm going to say it, even if you didn't want to go to class, perfect place to be. It's just all of these people here, even if I don't talk to them all the time, I could, without a doubt, pick up the phone, call, and say, hey, what's up, or call for a favor, and I have no doubt that they would drop what they're doing and help me out. Because that's the kinship, that's the friendship that you get here. It's just unbreakable, I think.
WIXQ. Radical. Renowned. Real. College Radio.
Do you suffer from severe lack of theater? Then try Cidamard. Side effects may include auditioning, directing, playwriting, or stage managing. Take every third Tuesday of the month.
Whoa. Take every first Wednesday of the month.
At 9:15 p.m. in Dutcher Hall's Studio Theater. For anyone experiencing side effects for more than 4 years, please contact an agent. And remember to check the call board for more opportunities. Join Cidamard. It's dramatic spelled backwards.
Angry Young and Poor is an independently owned record and clothing store that has been selling everything punk rock since 1995. They have an extensive collection of new and vintage vinyl records, punk and metal t-shirts, leather jackets, and Doc Martens. Angry Young and Poor is located on 356 West Orange Street in Lancaster. They are open from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. every day except Wednesday and Sunday. More information can be found on their website, angryyoungandpoor.com, or by calling 717-397-6116.
From the 50s through today, all the good little Johnnies listen to WIXQ.
From oldies to punk to metal, 91.7 plays the Johnny you want to hear.
This is your number one music source.
We're WIXQ, The Ville.
Yeah.
and the winter came and the sky fall to only bring the rain. I sat in darkness, all broken hearted. I couldn't find a day, I didn't feel alone. I never meant to cry, started losing hope. But somehow, baby, you broke through and saved me. You're an angel, tell me you're never leaving. Cause you're the first thing I know I can believe. Nights, you're the riverbank where I was baptized, cleansed from the demons that were killing my freedom. Let me lay you down, give me to ya, get you singing, babe. Hallelujah. We'll be touching heaven. You're an angel, tell me you're never leaving. Cause you're the first thing I know I can't believe.